atomic arrangement in solids. For a chemist, the important things that define the structure of a material are the chemical bonds and non-bonding interactions. However, for a materials engineer, although bonds are very important, we go beyond the bonds to examine how atoms are arranged within the material. We will look at the repeating arrangement of atoms that define a crystal, as well as defects that occur in those crystals. Both specific arrangement and the defect have important effect on properties such as strength. In this section, we will look at the structure of crystal. Before we begin to look in details, we need to know what a crystal is. Crystal is a structure where atoms or molecules are ordered in a self-similar repeating structure. While glass is a solid substance when atoms or molecules do not form any repeating structure. This is the atomic arrangement for two types of materials, crystals and glasses. Glasses is also called amorphous materials. Silicon is a crystalline, while an organic semiconductor is amorphous. We will use this figure to identify the difference in structure and properties between crystal and glasses. Crystal has more ordered arrangement of atoms. The average distance between atom in the crystal parallel to the bottom and along diagonal difference is different. The difference resulting in different value in physical property when measured in different direction. It is called anisotropy. The property will be different in different directions. However, the average distance between atom in glass parallel to the bottom along the diagonal is same. It is uniformity in all directions, or it is called isotropy. The property will be the same in all directions. If you pull glass rod that has a stiffness of, for example, 100 gigapascal and change by pulling it perpendicular to its strength, the stiffness will not change. It is because the glass is isotropic. Unit cells. In a crystal, the atoms form a repeating periodic array. This image shows a regular repeating pattern. The image shows possible repeating, although there are many others. You should notice it. You should also notice how some figures are not in single box. A repeating or a periodic array is just an arrangement of objects that repeat in this way. At the atomic level, a crystal is the three dimension, and the object are atoms. The unit cells of a crystal is a piece of crystal that repeat throughout the whole materials. We can think of the unit cell as three-dimensional unit that can be used to create the entire repeated pattern. there are 14 possible unit cells for crystals called Revis lattice. In this section, we will use just 3 of them for discussion. Simple qubit, body-centered qubit, and face-centered qubit. The number of atoms present in a unit cell is important. Figure out how many atoms are present in different cells. We can see there are 8 atoms in the figure of simple qubit unit cells. Because number of corner atoms is 8 multiplied by 1 over 8 in a unit cell, then there is one atom within one single cubic unit cell. We can see 9 atoms in the figure of body-centered cubic unit cells. Because number of corner atom is 8 multiplied by 1 over 8 and one atom in the center, then there is total 2 atoms within one body-centered cubic unit cells. We can see there are 14 atoms in the figure of face-centered cubic unit cells. Because number of corner atoms is 8 multiplied by 1 over 8 and number of face atoms is 6 multiplied by half, then there is total 4 atoms within one face-centered cubic cells. These unit cells figures are not completely realistic because they don't show the atoms at the correct size relative to the unit cells. The atoms are smaller than they should be. The purpose is to make overall arrangement is easier to see. This figure shows the atoms as spheres that are touching, which is a better representation on their size. The length of unit cells each is called the lattice parameter. Symbol for lattice parameter is A. Symbol R is atomic radius. In crystallography, the fraction of space occupied by the atom in a crystal is called atomic packing factor, APF. It can be calculated using this equation. APF equals volume of atom in unit cell divided by volume of unit cell. In simple cubic unit cell, the atom touch in this direction, so the A equal to 2R. Since simple cubic has one atom, the volume of atom per unit cell in a simple cubic unit cell is 1 times 4 over 3 pi R to the power of 3. The volume of a simple cubic unit cell is 8 to the power of 3, then APF for a unit cell is 0.52, meaning that 48% in a simple cubic unit cell is empty space. Density. A material density is defined as its mass per unit volume. So the density of a crystal is the mass of atom in a unit cell divided by the volume of the unit cells. The density will depend on the type of crystal structure of the crystal. This is data for many elements. We will now see calculating the density is similar to calculating the APC. Look at the aluminium. It has FCC structure, and four atoms are present in one unit cell of FCC. Atomic weight of aluminium is 26.98 gram per mole. Remember, if you have one mole of atom, you have Avogadro number of atom, which is 6.023 multiplied by 10 to the power of 23 atoms. The mass of one aluminium atom is in gram is 26.98 gram per mole divided by Avogadro number, then you will get 4.48 times 10 to the power of minus 23 gram per atom. Then the mass of one aluminium unit cell is 4.48 times 10 to the power of minus 23 gram per atom times 4 atoms, then you will get 1.79 times 10 to the power of minus 22. Directions to the atom touch is along a phase diagonal is 4R equal set to O, A equal 2, R set to. Volume of the unit cells is 6.62 times 10 to the power of minus 23 centimeter cubic. Then you will get density of aluminium is 2.70 gram per centimeter cubic. Calculated density is same as the value in the table given earlier.